That's the first measurement at the bottom of cylinder one. As you can see, the needle changes direction one unit below zero. Hello everybody and welcome to day 33 of my S-Type restoration. A few days ago I've been removing the crankshaft main bearings from the upper or core engine block and cleaning out the cylinder bores so that I now can check them for signs of wear. As I already mentioned, directly after lifting off the cylinder heads, the bores seem to be in a good shape. The honing pattern is still visible for the most part, but in between I noticed shiny spots here in each of the bores that indicate a higher amount of wear, so I will now perform a precise measurement on each of the cylinders with a dial bore gauge. The reading of such a gauge must not be understood as an absolute number. It only tells you how much bigger or smaller a certain diameter is compared to a reference size the gauge has to be adjusted to before. In my case, this reference size is the standard diameter of each of the cylinders, and therefore I have to take a look at the engine again. It's worth knowing that not all the cylinder bores and pistons of these AJ-V8 engines are the same size. There was a slight variation in production, ranging from 85.99 to 86.02 millimeters, and dependent on the concrete bore size, they fitted different pistons to the engine. The grade 1 piston was the smallest one, the grade 3 piston the biggest one. The grade of each bore, respectively piston, was then stamped into the engine block here at the left side besides the coolant drain plug. In my case it's 8 times the 2, so all of the bores and pistons are grade 2 and I don't have to take care of which number is related to which cylinder. If this wasn't the case, the numbers would be related as follows: number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, number 7, number 8. That's interesting because the official cylinder count on this engine is completely different. On the early engines, it's bank 1 or A, 1, 2, 3, 4, bank B or 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and on these later engines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Grade B means 86.00 up to 86.01 millimeters, so I will set 86.00 millimeters as my reference size. And since this gauge, as mentioned, cannot measure absolute sizes, I have to use a micrometer to do the adjustment. My micrometer has a range from 75 up to 100 millimeters, and before I can use it, of course, I have to check its own calibration. Therefore, these micrometers come with a piece of metal that hopefully is calibrated to here 75 millimeters. I put this piece of metal here in between, then gently close the micrometer. It's essential to grab it here and not there, because here a clutch is built in that prevents over tightening. And yes, that's 75 millimeters, 0.0. That means we can say this is calibrated. The measuring is performed here at the bottom, and the manual tells me to set this part as close as possible to the reference size. In my case I need 86 millimeters. That means I use this 85 millimeter stud plus a 1 millimeter washer. Now the micrometer has to be adjusted to 86.00 millimeters. 86.0. I just recognized that I made a big mistake when assembling this gauge. I moved this dial all the way down and screwed it on, but in this case the measuring pin will be blocked after a few hundredths of a millimeter. If correctly assembled, this part here has to move downwards, but not the dial itself. The dial has to stay in an upward position. It's now up to adjusting the gauge to 86.00 millimeters. I try to exactly center it here in between and adjust the dial to zero. It's not easy to find a middle position, but I think now this is achieved as close as possible. With the gauge calibrated, I will now do 7 measurements on each cylinder, one at the top, one at the middle, one at the bottom, both in front, rear and in left-right direction. And finally I will address these shiny spots where I suppose the dimensions to be out of spec. That's the first measurement at the bottom of cylinder 1. As you can see, the needle changes direction 1 unit below 0. Below means the diameter is 1 unit, 0.01 millimeters bigger than reference size. That's 0.03 off, and on top. .04 of a millimeter. That's interesting. Cylinder 4 on bank E at the middle is 0.02 of a millimeter even 0.03 smaller than spec. Up to the B-bank. And these are my results. As you can see, the cylinder bores are off between nothing and 0.07 of a millimeter. Surprisingly, the shiny spots haven't been an indication for excessive wear. Cylinder number 4 on the A bank is somehow an exception. It was off spec minus 0.03. That means that diameter was smaller than spec. Obviously, there has been a production problem with the cast iron liner of this cylinder. It's not bored out in the middle, so one wall is around 3 times as thick as the other one, and obviously that's why this liner could bend towards the inside, this 0.03. For calculating the piston to wall clearance, I still have to measure the pistons. I will do this next time. If you enjoyed today's video, please give it a thumbs up, or even hit the subscribe button. If doing so, please also ring the notification bell. See you back on my channel. Goodbye.